Hi Reddit, welcome to one of our Ziply central offices. This is where the action happens in our new fiber network that we're building. We have COs like this all over. We have nearly 200 of these buildings. This is one of our bigger offices, so we can show you what we do behind the scenes to make your internet service work. Over the last 10 months, we've deployed 700 miles of new cable. All of those cables terminate in buildings like this. You may have heard that we're spending $500 million on infrastructure over the next several years. I'm gonna show you what we've done in the last 10 months in this location so you can see how we're spending that money to improve your service. We thought it'd be great to give you a little tour. I'm gonna take you in. So come on in. We're gonna go through the battery room here. We've got lots of batteries like we do in most of our COs. We gotta walk all the way through to the vault. We hide our vaults at the very back of the building in most cases. Going into the toll room. This equipment's all the equipment that carries the voice in this location. Plus some fiber panels. We do have some fiber panels here. And here's where the magic happens, cable vault. This is all of the magic and how we get in and out of our buildings. We do that using these vaults because it allows us to let our technicians work inside. It also allows us to have lots and lots of conduits into the building. And you can see as we walk through this, this vault contains both copper and fiber. As we expand, we use these structures to overbuild our own copper network with fiber. That's how we bring fiber to a town without digging up every street. We have all these conduits and other infrastructure in the buildings and in the streets already. It puts us in a unique position to quickly build hundreds and hundreds of miles, like the 700 we've built so far this year, without any significant disruption to our users, because we have the capacity to operate both networks at the same time. So this is where our cables come into the building. We have all kinds of cables coming in here, and you can see our duct structures leave the building, and typically, like this building, they leave under our own parking lot, so we can control the dig up issues right near the building. These cables come in several types. You see these bigger ones. These are copper cables for phone service. And then you have fiber cables in interduct. So these are 1.5 inch or 1.25 inch interduct, depending on which one. And those are coming in through the same structure, bringing fiber cables into the building. You can see here, we've got air pressure going into these copper cables, making sure we keep the copper cables dry. As we move back in the vault, and these vaults are huge, we move to the area where they take these big outside plant cables and they splice them to cables that go to various parts of the building. And if you look above me, you can see there's all sorts of holes in the ceiling. And all those holes in the ceiling are the way we deliver cables into the rest of the facility. Our fiber to the home is just slightly further back, and that fiber to the home and business is much larger cables. And these cables, these black cables, are 864 fibers each. And they actually terminate into cases. You can see the counts on them, 1, 3, 8, 64. These are Tyco splice cases. And because we like to lay them on ladder racks like this, we actually wrap them in these splice bags. And I can't get this one off, but you can see the actual case. This is much like what you'd find on a pole. And we always use waterproof cases for these in case water gets into the vault. Facilities like this are super important to our redundancy. And like this one has 3 routes into it for our backbone. Many of our cities are configured the same way. And they're done like that so that when somebody digs up a cable, we don't have an outage for our customers. We operate all of that at 40% peak load. And we do that so that you can tolerate somebody digging up those cables without any disruption in your service. I'm gonna take you upstairs. We're gonna follow these yellow cables. You can see them going into the ceiling. They all go up right here. And we're gonna go look at the top of this hole right here from upstairs.